My name is Jessica. I'm 40 years old. I'm from Bullhead City, Arizona, and I have this lump under my left eye. It sticks out about an inch off of my face. It's squishy. I want to say it's hard, but it's not hard like a rock. It's hard like a stale marshmallow. I don't know, because you know how they get crusty on the outside, but yeah, that's about it. It's not painful for me except for when I touch it or move it. It feels kind of bruised, like right here underneath. And when I look down, I can't make anything out. It's blocking my vision. My bump started from an injury in 2008. The lifestyle that I was leading at the time left something to be desired, I guess. I ended up getting hit in the face with a pistol. The whole side of my face was black. And after it healed, it started forming. Past 2 years, it's grown significantly. And I've tried to have it fixed before a couple of times, but it's always something that keeps me from finishing the process. And I got in a car accident one time when I was on my way to the doctor's office. It's always something keeping me from getting it fixed. I completely lost hope. It's because I used to be a real pretty girl. I used to have like a lot going for me, and this happened, and it's affected my life drastically. My daughter Melissa lives in Michigan. I have not seen her in 5 years. The bump has affected my confidence. I think it's made me a little meaner too. I have 3 children, but when my kids were growing up, I wasn't around as much as I wanted to be or should have been because of the lifestyle that I led. My daughter Melissa, she's kind of angry about not having her mom around. We're trying to fix that. We're trying to fix that.
Hi, you're so beautiful. Give me a hug.
I believe how pretty you are.
Jeez Louise.
I'm extremely nervous about seeing Melissa because she hasn't seen my face since it's been this big. Did you have a good trip?
No. It was absolutely terrible. I'm not good with planes.
How are the babies doing?
Good. I'm going to show you some pictures if you want to see them.
You know I do. Look at that hair. I have 4 grandchildren. I've met my oldest grandchild, and I haven't met the other 3. I don't want to meet them with this on my face. Like, I feel like I look like a monster. What's wrong?
Nothing. I just really do want you to be around the kids and in their lives as much as possible.
I feel like there's a tension right now. You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. I just really do want you to come, like, see us. Yeah. We've talked about it, like, a lot. Not only am I still searching for my mom, now I'm searching for my kid's grandma and my mom. I definitely want my children to have a good and stable relationship with my mother. I want them to be able to call her grandmother and be happy to be around her, because I know how terribly it affected me as a kid to not have her around, and I want it to be better for them. I want her to be able to redeem herself, to have another chance at this.
You can see plain as day what's kept me from meeting the babies. I know it's atrocious, you know what I mean? I know where I messed up. I'm willing to do anything to fix that.
So I think the first step that we need to take is probably to get something done with the bump on your face. I mean, it is like genuinely concerning that that thing could be cancerous. It's like changed the shape of the bottom of your eye.
If Dr. Lee is able to help me, it would change so many things. My appearance, I would feel better about myself. I'd be able to be around my family more. There's nothing I can do about the past anymore, so move on to the future.
Hello, how are you?
Good.
You are Jessica. Well, I think I see why you're here already today, huh?
Yeah.
You've got this bump on your cheek.
Yes.
How long have you had this?
Years, really, but in like the past 2 years, it quadrupled in size. I can feel it touching my eyeball.
Oh, like your eyelashes, like pushing against your eyeball there.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. When this started, was it just like a little bump that you could squeeze or?
It actually ruptured one time under the surface.
Oh, okay.
And when it filled back up, I guess, or whatever, it came back
like,
with a vengeance.
So when it did rupture, did it get really red and inflamed or no?
It flattened. I thought it went away. It was only a couple of weeks and it had came back really strong.
I'm suspecting it's some type of cyst that, you know, ruptured, but the fact that it never really was exposed to the surface, you didn't get any bacteria that got involved. So it's what we call a sterile inflammation. And so it just started again, because a lot of times these cysts have like a little wall to them. And if even if it pops, if that wall is still there, it can fill
it
up again.
It back up, yeah.
So I'm gonna come up and take a little feel of it. Jessica seems pretty miserable with this big double eye bump here, and I can see why that would make you miserable. It's something that is really noticeable. It looks really painful, and the problem, though, right now is it's a little red and inflamed. It's right up against your eye. Gosh, it's so close. The good thing is that it moves around well, but the concern is that it's pretty big underneath there, too. And then it's also encroaching onto your eye socket, and right up against your squint muscles. And if there's a nerve that comes out of our cheek right along the midline of our pupil and along our nose here. So it's really close to that. It does look like a cyst though. So I'd like to give it a try, if you don't mind, to remove it. But I want to tell you about the risks. There's some things that are involved that I just need to make sure you know about. This is so big that it's really close to some of the nerves and muscles that you have there. In other words, there's a risk of us removing this and you might have a diminished sensation here. Also, there is the orbicularis oculi around your eye that allows us to open and close our eye. There's delicate nerves and really delicate muscles, many of them involved in the blinking of your eyes and, you know, your ability to see properly. There might be some damage to that muscle. So, are you okay with that?
Totally okay with that.
Oh, okay, I like that. I like that. That makes me feel good, too.
I'm super stoked.
Okay, good.
Thank you.
I'll see you in a little bit. Okay.
All right. Dr. Lee tells me that some of the concerns that she has is about the placement where it lays on my face. It's laying on the nerve right here and on top of my eye socket right here. I could lose movement in my face or whatever, but I'm willing to risk it. I would rather have a little numbness than have the bump any day.
All right, Jessica, we're gonna head in here.
I'm hoping we don't run into more risks once we get in there. I cannot leave with this on my face today. I've come too far. It means way too much for me to leave without it. Oh my God, it's beautiful.
The profile.
It's great.
Yeah, you see the potential.
Yeah, that's crazy. Thank you so much. Seeing my face in the reflection for the first time with no bump makes me feel elated and grateful and shocked. I haven't seen my face flat like that in a long time. I feel like the monster is gone, for sure. Thank you very much. Keep changing lives.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. You're so sweet. All right, see you later. Bye-bye.
I'm so excited to meet my grandbabies, and nothing's holding me back now. Like, the possibilities are endless.
It's been 4 months since I saw Jessica, and her eye looks incredible. She looks so pretty and feels so much happier than before. Jessica is so thrilled and ready to spend more time with her family and friends. God bless you, Jessica. I hope you get everything you want.